sponsored stream. What is it like to do a video feed thing with Azure machine learning stuff? So cognitive services, APIs for AI developers or regular developers too. This is meant to be accessible to everyone. You don't have to be a machine learning expert for it. We are gonna be doing it on video because I wanna eventually be able to get like the emotion from a video feed here and maybe like color the panel something different. Make it start turning red when I'm getting trolled. We're gonna be doing computer vision today. Like pass in a video, have it analyze some stuff. We may end up having to mix a few of these things together. We wanna go log into the portal then, right? We got this right here for face recognition. Completely brand new to this, so we're seeing what we do as a complete beginner. We're gonna need a face client or an SDK. And maybe this is how we end up wanting to do it. We analyze the image on just like a poll, like once a second. We're gonna wanna do these API calls. I'll probably wanna use the Python. Let's create a folder for this. So this is video mood detector. We are gonna want an ENV file, and inside of that we're gonna say Azure face key. There are two keys and there's an endpoint, so we'll call it key one, Azure face key two. There's the endpoint, and that ends up just having the project name that I have, CM Griffing face recognition.cognitiveservices.azure.com. They don't show the key, which is nice unless you make them. We got our endpoint here and we got the location. And this is in photos specifically. So yeah, the way we wanted to get like the mood from a video feed, that would probably involve sampling just an image from the feed on like an interval. Looks like we can use JavaScript for it. Oh, and we can try the face API in our browsers. So we'll check that out too. Here's our quick start into detecting faces using the REST API and JS. In the meantime, we can get an NPM install going. Probably want to do an NPM init. All right, so we got that added. So the face API is what we're using. Ah, perceived emotion. If we go grab this one, what mood do they detect? Contempt, sadness, and somewhat neutral. All right, one face detected. Try one more. I don't know what that one is. That one is surprise. Yeah, sounds about right. That is mostly surprise. So this is the main part, perceived emotion recognition. We can identify the facial hair, fancy. See if they'll actually identify this as a mustache. Press X to doubt. we'll see. We could do it from like a video feed. What I'm thinking here is to get like a live analysis of the video feed down in this corner here, we'll end up polling the video, sending that up on maybe like a 1 second interval. And I think that accomplishes what we're looking for. Their API even said up to 10 per second. I don't think we need that much fidelity. We could even go maybe like 2 per second and it's still worth it. This looks pretty straightforward too. It's just a post of the image. We have our params in here. We just make a post request. So we need to install some libraries. We're gonna do Axios. We can start out just sending one of the images we have like here on our desktop. So we'll do that. We're gonna create our script. We'll call it test.js. So we need to bring in Axios. We also need file system stuff. So we'll just do fs. We need an image. Image data equals fs.readFileSync. Oof.png for now. Gives us back a buffer. This giant URL, it's a post. So response is equal to axios.post. The endpoint is something we have in a .env file. So we're gonna have to bring that in. Let's see if I can remember what I named these keys. How do I reach these keys? So Azure endpoint? So image data, that might be okay, just sending the raw buffer. I don't think so, but we'll find out. This is where we set that key, application. So the key here ends up being, oh man, Azure subscription key. I really forgot what I have it as. Face key, okay. So let's start looking at this some more. So return face attributes is what we're looking for specifically. Ooh, how old do they think I am? This is gonna be, I want all of them. I want everything. Right, at least for these first couple, we'll do, yeah, all of it, every single one. So return face landmarks equals true. Return face attributes ends up being this string. So here's something interesting. Default value is 01, but they're saying 3 is recommended. Recognition model, 3? I think detection model is like finding the faces in the thing. Recognition is like identifying the attributes. I don't think we care too much about the return recognition model or detection model. So we're gonna remove those for now. So we have our URL crafted now. All right, so from here, we just do response data. We should probably do status as well. We can see the face API in action, and this is basically what we're gonna be calling out to. If we look at that oof, we see that is just almost pure happiness with a little bit of surprise. He's a surprised happy. So yeah, you call require.env.config. That call right there goes out for that .env file, and then it brings it in onto process.env. So yeah, let's try one more image just to show it off. Neutral, little bit of contempt, and happy. He's happy, neutral, contempty. So let's look at the data we're getting back. We sent oof.png. They give us like a head pose. I'm smiling in it, 100% smiling basically. Just as a reference, this is the image we're talking about, and now it's in your nightmares. Face landmarks. They even tell us where like the pupil and nose and all that stuff is. So landmarks is a cool one. When we get to attributes, we see head pose here and approximate gender. They think I'm 41. I look so young. It's gotta be the wrinkles, right? Let's try the PogChamp. So once again, the oof, 95% happy, little bit of surprise in there, and then none of the others. They are noticing that I'm wearing a beanie, 100% confidence in that one. Forehead is occluded, oh, fancy. But man, yeah, we're already there. We're getting responses. We actually made it farther than I thought, quicker than I thought for this part. The way to speed it up is use less of the recognition. For the most part, we are requesting too much data. Do we care about face landmarks? Nope. We don't necessarily care about the age, gender, head pose, smile, facial hair, or glasses even. All we care about for this is emotion. So we're using Recognition Model 3 because it's more accurate, but Recognition Model 1 might be faster. So first, let's get a baseline. That's pretty quick. Some of that time could even just be like the script spinning up. We just do performance.now and do our own subtraction. Time to run. End minus start. So we're looking at 835, I believe, milliseconds, which means polling on like a 1 second interval makes a lot of sense. Let's try one of the other recognition models. Recognition one, we see it improved by about 100 milliseconds. We see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 different emotions. That's what we would use to maybe determine the color to display. That would end up being part of maybe the last step we need. So what we need to do is somehow figure out how to extract the current frame from my video. Once we can get that, we can save the output to some JSON file and then have some OBS overlay query that JSON file on a timer. Maybe this is the part we hold off on then. So we're gonna have a server, which means we need to install Express. And you know what? Let's go get some Express.js boilerplate. Let's just grab the hello world, app.get. We do some async. We need some FS extra. And we use FS extra to get promise-based file system stuff. So then here, what we end up doing is const emotion data. That'll be equal to await fs.read file. And that file will be here and we'll just call it emotion.json. When we spin up this server, we also simply want to do something like this, set interval, and inside of it, yeah, we want this happening like every second. And this ends up being our test upload functionality. We're also going to have an images array. We got hmm.png, oof, pogchamp, sure, suspicious, and we'll do ugh. Here, we simply grab image data as this. This is images.length. Start at 1, modulo by that. As we get the image data here, that's where our little upload script ends up going. So we're gonna get that response. The image data is this thing we're dynamically loading in now. We're passing our key, get the response back, and then we can do fs.write file, and we'll just do it to emotion.json. This is a totally different thing. This is just gonna be overlay. And then here, we just simply want to have maybe overlay.html. And in here, we want to do body background transparent. So then in here, we can just do set interval. This could end up having some lag, which we don't care too much about. We'll just say 500. While we're doing this interval, we're going to do axios.get localhost 3000 emotion. Here, we almost need a way of determining what color to get. What do we want to call this? Colors? And we actually want this to be an object in which the keys are these values. We could just copy these, now that I think about it. So anger is going to be red. For contempt, green? Maybe like more like an orange? Disgust? Purple? Sure. Fear? Maybe just a gray? Happiness will make green? neutral should probably be transparent, huh? And surprise, we'll make like a yellow. I think it works. All right, so we got those colors. When we come back here with a response, and we'll set it to neutral by default. So now for each of these, we have a key, and we can loop over this. Highest value equals emotion data dot neutral. If emotion data, it's greater than the highest value, we set the highest value. We loop through these, we grab the highest one. This isn't gonna account for like when two emotions are exactly equal. This is just a quick, hey, is it even working type script. We can use the emotion we extracted, grab the color for it. We do style, background color, and we set it equal to color. All right, so moment of truth. Hey, there we go. So it seems like most of my images end up being transparent, happy, and then bam, yeah, we have the source over here in the overlay. And ideally, if we were showing the image, that would be good too. And keep in mind, this is still just kind of hacking at it because ideally this would be overlaid over a video feed that we're extracting the image from. So the way we're hacking the image into the response here, not ideal, but it's at least to like show us the image it's seeing, what color it's overlaying over it. We're gonna call it just images for now. With that there, we can serve up the image and we can put that onto the response data here. And in our overlay, we're gonna end up putting an image in here. Class equals mock image. Class equals wrapper. Mock image goes inside of it. Padding 0, margin 0. Get that nice and reset. Got mock image in there. Wrapper is then position relative. And we're also going to have a thing called image color. We set that to background transparent. And we want to make this have position absolute. Top 0, right 0, bottom 0, and left 0. Images, and this is where the value from emotion data comes back. So emotion data dot image. Let's go double check it over here now. Hey, and there we go. Now we're getting some of it. The object fit doesn't seem to be taking as much effect as it should, but bam, that's pretty good. So what we're seeing with transparent here is that transparent just makes it neutral makes it just transparent. So yeah, that's cool. Let's go look at some of our color data though. And where we see transparent, it is more neutral than something else. Maybe instead we just, we don't do neutral. They think that one's happy though. Questionable. I might have messed up the colors. That's the only thing I can think of. Those look right to me though. So the way we're doing some of this is off, right? The highest value detection. But yeah, not bad. So what we're doing, let's go kind of look through the code and see what we're doing in our server. The important part is we're pretending that we're parsing a video feed. Instead, we're just doing a loop over a set of predefined images. Eventually, that might just be a quick and easy replacement of just parsing the current image. When we get that current image, we read that. This is maybe turning it into like actual image data. And then we pass that through to this API for the Azure endpoint. And we've seen that endpoint. It is fairly simple. We're not logging it, but it comes back with just some data. So it says where the face is within the image, and it says what attributes it has on it, and here we're selecting which attributes we care about. The more you add, the longer it takes to run. How much are these going to cost me? 300 requests. Average latency, they're saying 310, so I've got some of my own like network latency going. So it's an estimated 40 cents for 1,000 calls? Okay, we're totally good. That's not bad. Here's the thing we want to do. Why is anger not working? As we loop over these things, what's going on? It's probably something so simple. I'm gonna be exhibiting the anger dealing with this anger bug, right? We see happiness. Oh, we see neutral even after anger. That would be part of it. Ah, there we go. So now we're getting sadness, happiness, anger. All right, hey. All right, cool. Let's get the overlay showing as well. So imagine that's my webcam. We're sampling it once a second, and the overlay is just something where it might be like the border of the image. All right, we could eventually turn this into like an OBS plugin. The user enters their like Azure credentials, then they're on the hook for the cost. That could be really fun. We had a lofty set of goals. This part, done. The part that we're not doing is extracting the image from a video, and then after video, use live feed. None of this part is done. Hard-coded video first, then this second. Man, I am really happy with how quickly some of this stuff came together. Let's do a final, like, hey, here's what we did today. Here's what we didn't quite do today. We weren't able to get this, but we were able to test with static images, upload them to Azure, and get back some emotion data from it. And we see that process happening right now. We're imagining that we're just sampling a video feed at 1 second intervals. We're uploading and getting a response back. And from there, our video overlay would then have a color applied to it. So here we see with some of these images as they come back, it's either mainly happy, surprised, there's anger, there's sadness. We didn't have one that's mainly disgust or contempt though, or fear. We get these values back from sending an image. We weren't able to extract image from a video. And admittedly, I wasn't even sure how to do that, and I'm still not sure how to do that. But we want to use FFmpeg, which is, you know, just a library for parsing and manipulating video. This part we may look into at another point, just to get the thing working here on stream. Because we couldn't figure this part out though, we wanted to make sure we're still like getting stuff done. So we wanted to get an overlay in OBS going, where it's just like maybe a square of the color we'd be doing. We're using our images inside of there to show you like which one got parsed into which color. Because it's not a live feed, we're doing it with just static images looping through them as if I was making faces. So if we go and see it in effect, this is it just right there in the browser for debugging and testing. We created a very minimal server for representing and holding some of this data and serving it up to the browser overlay. We can then look inside of OBS and bam, we have this browser source that we would then overlay over an actual camera instead of these hard-coded images, and voila. So let's actually look at what we did to make that server and make some of that plumbing actually work together. So we're doing a standard Express app. We got our app, our port. We got some Azure credentials, such as the endpoint we're hitting that relates to our specific service within Azure, and our key, which we don't want to show you, so we have it inside of our environment variables. Some of the core stuff, right? We're using .env to hide away the environment variables. We're using Express, like I mentioned, and we're using Axios to post our image data to the Azure API. And then FS Extra we used because we wanted our file system stuff to be promise-based, regardless of which version of Node we're on. I believe the latest version of Node actually does have a promise interface. We're just not using it. We use FS Extra for that. Here we have, you know, our hard-coded images, and here where we're doing this interval, that is also kind of like the mocking out. If we were processing the feed, this is what it might be grabbing as an image from that feed. And we're just uploading that using Axios here. So our endpoint goes in, and we see that there's a bunch of stuff we can pass to this. We can go dig into a few more of like the face attributes type stuff, right? Right now we're just extracting emotion, but you can extract all sorts of data from it. We got recognition 3. This is the model used to like parse this thing. Theoretically, recognition 03 is more accurate, whereas maybe recognition 01 we saw was maybe 100 milliseconds faster. Based upon what you're looking for, accuracy or speed, you can pick one. In our case, the 100 milliseconds doesn't matter that much, so we're not too worried about it. We're uploading the image data, and then our headers, we just simply say, yeah, we're uploading raw binary, you know, just octet stream, and then here goes our key as a header. That's the simplest way to just try it out. You can just pass your data to Azure and get back the response that we see right here. From there, a little bit of the plumbing is we end up creating a get endpoint within our local server. This gives us the emotion data into our overlay. And then here, overlay is just the HTML page that is the overlay. So the overlay is communicating with itself, so we don't have to deal with cores. Here we have the images that we're serving up. That's basically just mock data. You wouldn't actually be showing that in the real thing of this. The server is quite simple. Here's some of our images that we're using to parse and get some data from it. Imagine this was over a video feed, and we were pulling an image out of the video feed in real time at like an interval of once per second. We could detect what emotion I am showing in my video feed, like right here, and then put an overlay over it as I get angrier or as I get happier or things like that. This right here is a real world application of, in my stream, I wanna put a color over my video feed when I get angry. You could totally do that. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed that. All the stuff we did is actually quite simple.